الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على السلام حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء وتساءلوا به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما يا عباد الله اعلموا أن خير الكلام كلام الله وخير هدى وخير هدي هدي محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإياذ بالله يا عباد الرحمن يا نعمة الله بإذن الله سبحانه وتعالى today we pass on the journey we call in the journey of Abi al-Anbiya Qalil al-Rahman Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam, we pass on his journey. So it's very important to know the history of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam. We can learn more about his history, his seerah to Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam. The great man, the greatest man, Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam, of all the Ibrahimic religion, the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam, when a person come to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he addressed to him, He said, oh, the best man of them all mankind, our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he saw of his modesty, and then he said, no, I'm not the great mankind. He said, the great mankind is Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam. And the same man, he said, no, you are the best man. He said, no, the best man is our father, is my father Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam. A single man, a single most respected human being on the face of the earth. Because every single majority religion of this year, the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam, the Jew, the Christian, and the Muslim tradition are calling Ibrahim tradition. Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam, because the look of Ibrahim alayhi salam, the great venerating human being in this earth. The history of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam, Ibrahim is the prophet, Nabi Allah alayhi salatu wa salam, or Prophet Muhammad as well praise him well, and the Quran mentioned his name more than 70 times in the Quran, 17 verses in the Quran. And in fact, all the person that the Quran had is the one man, is the one man. Allah tell him to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to look after him, to look him as a role model. Because Allah said in the Quran, قَدْ كَانَتْ لَكُمْ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ فِي إِبْرَاهِيمَ. Is a one man. Allah tell him, tell to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to look for guidance to Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa sallam. We remember him, Ya Ibadallah. We remember Ibrahim in Hajj, alayhi salatu wa salam. We remember him in the journey past. We have passed the journey of Ibrahim, Al-Eid al-Adha. We already passed on it, but all those things make us remember of Ibrahim, alayhi salatu wa salam. Bi-iznillah subhanahu wa ta'ala, maybe we can learn a lesson from today, bi-iznillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibrahim alayhi salam was born in the place he was born when there was no believer in the Eid on the time. The time when Ibrahim alayhi salam was born, there's no believer who believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There was no monotheism in the Eid. At a young age, at a teenager, he was guiding from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to monotheism. And he know that the idol and worship the sun, the moon, the stars are false gods. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him a lightning, his heart and his mind as wisdom from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam, the message of monotheism, as the young age, when everyone on his society, everyone on his community, they was worship idol. They was worship idol. As a teenager, around 14, 15, he realized that there's no God but Allah, the creator of all mankind. When he addressed to his father, he said, oh my father, he addressed his father with a polite manner and a gently. He addressed on his father with a polite manner and gently. He said, Iskola li abihi ya abati, lima ta'budu ma la yasma. Lima ta'budu ma la yasma, wa la yubsir, wa la yugni anka shay'a. He said, oh my father, oh dear my father, why would you worship which can neither hear you, which can neither benefit you, which can neither harm you from nothing? Why you worship something like that? And then he said again, Ya Abati, inni qad ja'ani min ilma lam ya'tika, fattabi'ni ihdika siratan sawiyya. He said, Oh my dear father, indeed, there was come to me a knowledge. That knowledge is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Which knowledge to you? So follow me, is gonna guide you. Ya ibadallah. And then he said to his father again, Ya abati, la ta'budi shaytan, inna shaytan kana li rahmani asiyya. He said, Oh my father, don't follow shaytan. Don't follow shaytan. Don't worship shaytan. You have to know that a shaytan is disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A shaytan is our enemy. And then he said, Ya abati, inni aqafu an yamassaka adabu min al-Rahman, fattakuna lishaytan waliyya. He said to him, Don't worship shaytan, don't follow shaytan, follow me. Allah has given me some wisdom, some knowledge, what you don't know. Please, my father, follow me. I will guide you fi sirat al-mustaqim. But his father doesn't let him, his father tell him, Oh my son, what you can come to teach me something, what my forefather hasn't teaching me. I cannot stop that. And then Ibrahim alayhi salam, when he fell for the da'wah of his father, and then he moved to his community, he went to his people, he went to his society, he called them for da'wah. He said, Qala ata'budu ma tanhitun. You worship something what your own hand had been created. Your own hand made something, and then after you worship that one. And then he said, Wallahu khalaqakum wa ma ta'malun. You don't know that it's Allah hasn't created you. Why you worship something? You bow down on something. What your own hand had fabricated something, and then you worship that. He said that to his society, his people. That time, Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam, he was a teenager. He was a young teenager. That show us, as a young man, don't look your age. What you can do for the sake of Allah, get up and then do it. This is show us, Ibrahim alayhi salam, is a lesson for us to learn for this, what Ibrahim had did this time. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to the sirat al-mustaqim. Ya ibadullah, ya ibadurrahman, ni'matullah. I want to tell you, Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam, he showed to his people some wise, gentleman's as da'wah. What he did, he already know the sun, the moon, and the star, all they are created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But what Allah has given him some wise, what he did, he used that wiseness. He used to tell to those people to worship who? To worship the sun and the moon. He tell them, but he already know these people, this sun and the moon and the star, they have been created by Allah. But he tell them by wise, because he want to get them, he want them to come to Allah, to come close to Allah. So he tell them to worship, to know that the sun and the moon, they have been the operator. And in the last, one by one, he proved by proving that the moon and the sun, they are creator of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya ibadallah. So he debated with them. He debated with them as young age. As young age, very young age, he was debating with his people. He was one man, whole nation. That time, there's no believer in the earth. But he get up, he stood up, he said, he wanna fight for justice. He's the one man who get up and he fight for justice. Ya ibadullah, we have to understand that, we have to learn the importance, the bravery, the importance, and then the commitment of standing for the truth and the justice for the sake of Allah. Ya ibadullah, we have to imagine that in our time, when it is difficult, even minority of us, what we cannot do. That's why Allah called Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, Inna Ibrahim kana umma. In the Quran, he said that Inna Ibrahim kana umma, ummatan qanita lillahi hanifa. Ya Ibadallah, we have to understand that what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the da'wah, the onelessness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then, Ibrahim, what exactly he wanna know about Allah? He already know. He wanna challenge the entire community. And then, what he wanna know again? He said, he know where Allah standing for him. Because Ibn At-Taylah said, he said for his God, he said, if you want to know where you stand with God, the first thing, look where God stands with you. Look where God stands with you. That's why Ibrahim alayhi salam, he want to know that. Ya Ibadallah, his community, his people, they stand, they want to persecute him, they want to torture him, and then they want to kill him. One of the king is named Namrud. Namrud, he built his fire. He built big fire, very strong fire. They said they want to throw Ibrahim in that fire. And then what happened? Ibrahim alayhi salam, he trusted in Allah. He put his trust in Allah. He was alone in all the year. He was alone. He was one ummah. There was nobody with him. Even his grandfather, was not in his side. In his grandfather was the side of the world idol worshipper, in the side of Namrud. And then Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam, when they want to put him in that fire, but the first thing, he called Allah first. Everything happened to you, you have to call Allah. Because he said, وَقَالُوا حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِئِمَ الْوَكِيلُ. I will repeat again. حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِئِمَ الْوَكِيلُ. I don't have no one. Allah is a sovereign for me. Allah is everything for me. Allah is my protector, is my designer, is my creator. That's what Ibrahim was doing. So now when they was ready, they want to put Ibrahim in the fire. They want to throw Ibrahim alayhi salam in the fire. He was alone. He was one ummah in that age. Ya Ibadallah, the time is gone. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر لذنبي فإنه هو غفور رحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. تقدم. Just get inside. Please give them seat because they're standing outside. Please give them seat. تقدم. 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 فاسفهوا فاسفهوا في المجالس فاسفهوا. يا عباد الله. إبراهيم عليه السلام. When they throw him in the fire. When they throw Ibrahim in the fire, Malaika come to him. He said he want to save him. He said to Malaika, you know, who sent you? Malaika said, is Allah sent me to come to protect you, to take you out from this fire. He said, when you come, Allah was there. He said, Allah was there. Okay, go. I want Allah to save me. Subhanallah. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. This is Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, the greatest man in the year. And then when the malaika go, Allah say in the Quran, Allah special talk to the fire. He said, kunna ya nar kuni bardan wa salaman ala Ibrahim. He said to the fire, Allah called the fire in direct, immediately he talked to him. He said, oh fire, be a coolness and a peace and a comfort to Ibrahim. And then this is for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, most high, most supreme. He saved Ibrahim. The time Ibrahim is dead, the thing Ibrahim is gone, but alhamdulillah, Allah has saved Ibrahim. Because of time, inshallah, bismillah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is gonna be the series. It's very important to know about Ibrahim, because we pass on the journey of Ibrahim. The journey of Ibrahim from Mecca, we learn about him. We remember him in Makkah to Mukarrama to Madinah to Munawwar. And then in here, in Eid, who doesn't go to Makkah? Who doesn't go to Hajj? We will remember him in our Eid. We have to know who is Ibrahim. We have to know his entire history. It's a part of our deen. It's a part of Islam. We have to learn our Islam. The Prophet says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for learning your deen, for learning this Islam, this deen is the faridatan for kulli muslima. It's the fardan, faridan for all Muslims. We have to learn about our deen, ya ibadallah. And then Ibrahim put his trust in Allah. We can learn about him because Allah says in the Quran, وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُ وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُ. If you put your trust in Allah, Allah will protect you. He will protect you. He will take care of you. Because he's the Creator, Most High, the Supreme One. What he can give you, no one cannot give you. But Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam, that Allah said in the Quran, Ibrahim, he was one ummah in the Eid. Nobody was there. Nobody was there. That's why the mufassirin of this ayah, Ibrahim, inna Ibrahim kana ummah. The mufassirin of this ayah, they said Ibrahim was the entire nation. He was one ummah, one person for all entire nation. What good he can perform, entire nation cannot perform it. What good thing he can do, the entire nation cannot do. That's why Allah called him one ummah. Whatever you are, true, the truth and the justice stand for the sake of Allah. Nobody cannot harm you. Allah said in Hadith Qudsi, he said, our first people from Adam alayhi salam to our last people, they be together, and the jinn, the first of the jinn, and the last of the jinn, if they are be together, they want to harm you. No one cannot harm you. No one cannot harm you if you stand it for the truth and for justice. Because of the time, and then the place is very calm. Inshallah, bismillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inna Allah wa al-malaikatu yusalluna ala al-nabi.
Ya ayyuha
al-lazina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslim. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. Barik ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. Kima barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala Ali Ibrahim. Ila alameen innaka al-hamidu al-majid. Allahumma aizza islam wa al-muslimin. Wa hadhu shirki wa al-mushrikeen. ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين. اللهم اغفر المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات والأحياء ومنهم أموات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا آتنا من لدنك رحمة وهب لنا من أمرنا رشدا. يا عباد الله, this I say the lesson of Ibrahim. We have to do our best to learn about Ibrahim. Inshallah, next week we're gonna continue where we stop. Inshallah, ya ibadallah, inna Allah ya'muru bil adli wal ihsan wa ita'i dhil qurba wa yanha 'anil fahsha'i wal munkar wa baqiya ya'izukum la'allakum tadhakkarun. Aqimus salah.